Creating backup jobs in Portal is pretty easy, but it is a manual process that can become cumbersome for large or dynamic organizations. This video introduces a feature in Carbonite Server Backup designed to help with this problem, called Agent Autoconfiguration. In short, Agent Autoconfiguration automatically assigns a custom-designed backup job to Windows agents as they register to Portal, which can save a ton of time for organizations who would otherwise need to manually copy a set of backup configurations one by one across a large number of agents. A few things to note. You must first set up and enable job templates for the sites in Portal before installing the agents. Any agents that are installed before job templates are enabled will not be able to use them. This feature is only available in Windows agents version 8.90a and newer. Also, this feature can only work on agents that have been installed with a default encryption password. During the agent installation, you'll see this screen. To use auto-configuration for the agent, select Yes and create a default encryption password. Please ensure you keep this password safe, as it cannot be recovered later and is necessary for auto-configuration to work and to restore backups in the future. To use this feature, we first need a job configuration template. Job configuration templates can be assigned to child sites, and every agent that registers to the child site will use the job settings from the template by default. For standard SaaS customers, job configuration templates are pre-populated for you, but you will have the option to customize them. Let's log into Portal as a parent site admin now to demonstrate how to customize and assign a default job template to a child site. After logging in, click the Sites tab, then open the child site for which you'd like to assign a job template. Then click the Agent Configuration tab for the site. Here you can turn auto configuration on and select the job template that you want to automatically apply to every new agent that registers to a Portal user in this child site. Then select a Vault profile. New agents in the site will back up data to the Vault account selected here. When you select a job template, you can click View to see the included settings and make sure it's the one you want. If you wanted to customize this template, you could click the Create a Copy Editable button. This will create a brand new job configuration template based on the originally selected one. In this new template, you can edit all the options to your preference, including the name and description, what to protect, retry options, and retention settings. We'll go into more detail about each of these fields later in the video when we show other types of customers how to create job templates from scratch. To set your template, just click Save, and auto job configuration is now set for this child site. On-premise customers, value-added resellers, and infrastructure managed service providers do not have any pre-populated job templates and will need to create them. To create a template, log into Portal as a super user. Click Global Settings in the top menu. Then click Job Templates. This screen lists any job templates that are already created. To make a new one, click the Actions drop-down at the top and select Create Job Template. The Create New Job Template window will appear. This is where you'll establish the backup job settings that you want to automatically apply to new agents. Select a job type, either local system or image. Local system jobs back up individual files and folders and are created using the Windows agent alone, while image jobs snapshot the entire system using the image plugin. Then enter a name and description. Mark this checkbox if you'd like the job to retry after a failure. Then enter how many times you want the job to retry and how long to wait between tries here. Over here, you can select to make this job bare metal restore capable, which includes the OS drive and allows you to restore the backups from this job directly to new or blank hardware, or to protect the entire server, which will include every available and hidden drive on the server in the backup, and automatically includes bare metal restore capability. If you are creating a local system template, you can enter the drive letters and folders to include or exclude in the backup here. Because we're creating a template to apply to any agent, there's no folder tree to browse. You'll have to type drive letters and folders manually one at a time. After each entry, just click Include or Exclude, depending on what you want the job to do with that location. When entering directories, wildcards are unnecessary. The rule will automatically apply to all child objects of the entered driver directory. Also, the more specific the directory, the more precedence it takes. So for example, if I want to include all but one directory of the C drive in this backup job template, I can use a rule to include the whole C drive, then another rule to exclude the folder on the C drive that I don't want. Since the exclude rule contains a more specific location than the include rule, it will take precedence and will not be overridden by the rule that includes the whole drive. The backup set window below will update as you add each rule. If any locations entered here don't exist on the agent, those rules will simply be ignored. At the bottom, you can schedule the job by setting the retention type, schedule, compression, deferring, and priority. When setting the schedule, there are three modes to choose from: days of the week, days of the month, or custom. When choosing days of the week or month, you'll be presented with options that you can click directly to define the schedule. Let's say you would like this backup to run twice a month, at the middle and at the end of each month. In this case, you would select days of month, then click a day near the middle of the month. I'll choose the 15th. And last, which will run the backup on whatever the last day of the month is. Then click OK. This backup will run on the 15th and last days of every month. You'll also notice in this window that when scheduling by days of the week or month, the backup will run at a randomly assigned time. This is to prevent all the backups automatically configured with this template from running at the same time, which could reduce performance due to bandwidth issues. If you were to create a custom schedule, you could use the convention described here to create an even more specific schedule, where you can define the start time and change the schedule between months. However, it should be noted that since custom schedules are not run at random times, all the agents assigned this template will run backups at the same time and may run slowly because of it. So just use caution when creating custom schedules. For further customization, you can assign multiple schedules by clicking the Add Schedule button. To remove a schedule, click the trash can icon next to it. When you're done configuring, click Create Job Template. Your new global job template will appear in the list and is now ready to be used by parent site administrators as we demonstrated earlier.